So let's talk about the customer experience for the first purchase that you mentioned is so crucial. And you
Yes.
said that it has to be consistent, it has to be very high quality. How do you think about curating the buying experience from start to finish? Can you walk me through how that works? If I want to buy a Ferrari in China, what do I do? Do I go direct to Ferrari? Do I go to a dealership? What, how do you curate that experience?
But the experience is a journey because first of all, you identify the car. We have good coverage. All the main city have a dealership, and then the workshop and the after sales is much broader coverage. But they say that we have a strategy only focus on the flagship stores in flagship city. Let me put it in this way. So we actually bring the client within the Ferrari family. As soon as they come into the dealership, they have to feel an experience. They have to feel the corporate identity. When they enter the dealership, they are already inside the Ferrari world, and the CI is the corporate identity of the shops, the way we decorate the shop, the color we choose, and all the touch point inside the showroom are the same all over the world. So basically, the experience when you enter first is it should be at least, but it is at least in China, similar to any other showroom in the world. So then, once inside, you have to feel the luxury from one side, but also the exclusivity. Because honestly, with you, our product should be considered very exclusive. Because in the world, we are selling just all in all 10,000 cars. So when you sell 10,000 cars, you are, there are very few cars around. Even if you consider that a Ferrari never actually died, and we never deregister a car. This is a very unique situation for our brand. Somebody buy a Ferrari and then keep it forever, or it will sell to someone that he will keep it forever, or this one will sell to somebody else that will keep it forever. But at the end of the day, no one actually deregister and smash a car into. It's never a piece of metal. It's always a nice car to drive. So sorry for this, but it's worth to say. So you enter the showroom, and then you immediately have to feel, normally to feel the Ferrari world. We have normally a certain requirement for our dealership, and you have to expose the all existing the whole range in production at that time. So when you enter, you have the full range available, and the person will drive you around the showroom to explain different cars and to explain all the different kind of performance and potential personalization you can have in the car. We have an area of the showroom dedicated to personalization with a nice sofa and all the samples that you can choose, color, virtual personalization. So it's quite an experience actually, and I would say that if you come in with a precise idea of which car you want, is easy, because you come in, you say, look, I'm very well prepared, clients, maybe a repeater, and I know what I want. But the best solution is when you don't know what you want, and we drive you through the overall experience. And we how to say, we build up your awareness of the brand, and we build up your demand. So I think this is, to be honest, quite common in the luxury business in overall, no matter car, no matter watches. I mean, you need to accompany your clients in the journey, and everyone has his own journey. I mean, the process and the model is the same, but then everyone has his own journey. and then you drive it through the different aspects. Then let's assume that you decide to the model, then you wanted to personalize. We have different grade of personalization. You can go through choosing simply the color of the car or the color of the interior to decide and build up your own color. I mean, we have hundreds of colors, but you can even decide which color you want, even if it's outside our enormous amount of color that we have for both interior and for everything, for every single component. And you can go up to what we call one-off, that you build up your own car. Of course, with very few limitations, that is mostly the chassis. But once you have the chassis, then you can build up your own car. So you can understand, this is not very common, to be honest, because you need to be affluent to do that. But is an experience. So you can personalize your car from simply choosing a color to go up to the maximum level of personalization, that is the one-off car. So this is choosing the problem part. Then once you choose your product, you will have what we call a contact plan, because normally you have to wait to have a Ferrari. This is typical. Not because we want to have a waiting list, but because the capacity is relatively limited. And as I said, the 10,000 cars, and the demand is much higher than the capacity. So simply, there is this lag and you have to wait. So, of course, there are different waiting lists for different models. You can go from a minimum of 12 months to a maximum of 36. Could happen. You have to wait 3 years for your car. And so, from the moment you place the order to the moment you receive your car, there is what we call a contact plan. Contact plan that is very interesting because there are several things inside. I don't want to bother you with detail, but basically what happens, you take the hand of your clients the day you place the order after finishing the personalization. And then you keep in touch with him, showing him where is your car and which level of accomplishment that your car has done. You send some a model of the car. There is we have a cooperation with a very nice modeling company that is called Amalgam. It's British, I think. And we have an agreement with them. And at a certain moment of the contact plan, they build up a similar model, extremely detailed, of the car that you're going to receive later on. So, for example, if it's a F8 Tributo, you will get yellow with a brown interior. You will receive a yellow F8 with brown interior and exactly the same configuration of the car that you will see a few months later. And then we have several others things inside the contact plan. That change a bit on the culture, on the countries, but roughly we keep you update about where your car is and how long you need to receive it. And then there is the delivery of the car. The delivery of the car is a ceremony. We have a ceremony inside the showroom. There is an area dedicated to the delivery. And you receive your car with certain additional things that the certificate of the car and a few things, but we emphasize a lot this part because we believe it was always like that, but it is also now is like this. When you buy a Ferrari, especially if it's the first one, you have a sense of accomplishment because, I mean, if you are, I don't know, a banker, you make a big deal and they buy the Ferrari. If you are an entrepreneur and you did the big business and you buy the Ferrari, or you are an actor or a football player and you reach, you sign up the big contract and you buy the Ferrari. So there is always an accomplishment behind the purchasing of this car. And so we, since ever, we celebrate this moment. And then the moment you have the car, sorry if it's long, but there is,
it's important,
it's quite a story. So the moment you become an owner, then you enter the club of the Ferraristi. In the past was less built up. Now is with the digitalization of the society, is becoming more and more easier. We have one or even two, if I remember, but let's say one is dedicated to the clients. We have one app where you subscribe, and then you become part of the family. So whatever event we will have in the future in your area or in any other area in the world that you would like to join, like a cavalcade or like a reunion or like whatever, there are plenty of things inside. You can join the Ferrari Owner Club that is organizing a social event, social gathering, and many other things. I mean, many, many things. But the club, becoming part of the family, is an essential part of the post-delivery experience. So coming back to your question, the journey starts when you enter the showroom and you actually buy the car. But then it will never finish in the years to come till you have the ownership of the car. And the more you develop your passion, so more car you buy, the more you enter into a more and more selected area of clients that you can access to new models, special models. For example, if we launch a special model, normally we have certain criteria to allocate the car. The car are not on the market. Don't come with the money, you buy and you go. You need to have certain criteria. Every time is different. But normally we tend to deliver or to allocate special series car, limited edition, to collector. So it's a complex way to say that you enter the family, and if you like it, because it happens sometimes that they don't like to stay in, but very few, you become a member of a global club with several local branches, let me put it in this way, and you become part of a family.